Are there really two types of science? Welcome to Critical Thinking Scan, where we look at how you can think about any faith-challenging message and arrive at a biblical, logical conclusion yourself. I'm Patricia Engler, and today I'll unpack the difference between those two types of science which are so important to know for thinking critically about many messages. Observational science, which makes measurements in the present, and historical science, which makes assumptions about the past. Now, when I was in university, I heard that there is no difference between these two types of science. I heard that interpretations about supposed events in history, like evolution, are just as much facts as observations about the present, like the effects of gravity. But is that true? Well, let's think about it. First, even some famous evolutionists like Ernst Mayr recognize that ideas about evolution, unlike observations from fields like chemistry, are historical science. Of course, the fact that a famous scientist says something doesn't make it true. But in this case, we can use common sense to check for ourselves. And common sense tells us that there is a difference between fact and assumption. Fact is the domain of observational science, which uses the scientific method to produce repeatable, testable experiments and descriptions about things in the present. Observational science is how we discover medicines and develop technologies and describe animal anatomy. It's what I did in my university labs, the kind of science that can help us identify what fish species a fossil is or measure a gun barrel at a crime scene. But observational science can't tell us exactly how the fish became a fossil or who shot the gun, because those are events that happened in the past, so we can't observe them directly in the present. And that's where historical science comes in. Historical science draws conclusions about the past based on observations in the present. Well, that requires assumptions and speculations and educated guesses to fill in for gaps in the facts. And those assumptions will be influenced by our worldviews. So while we all have access to the same facts, we interpret those facts through different worldview lenses to draw different conclusions about the past. But we can't directly test those conclusions because we cannot rewind history. For example, say you were investigating a murder. You'd go to the scene of the crime and make observations. Maybe you'd find some fingerprints or footprints or a murder weapon. Those are the facts of the case, the observational science. And you would take those observations to court, where different attorneys would interpret those same facts to present different stories about the past. So the prosecution might say, well, clearly the fingerprints on the weapon mean that the culprit is Colonel Mustard. But then the defense might come along and respond, no, it was Miss Scarlett who used gloves to fire Colonel Mustard's gun, so then she framed him that way. So there's this debate going on as the different sides with different starting points look at the same observations to draw different conclusions about the past. Well, let's think of another past event, human origins. Where did we come from? To find out, we could make observations in the present. By observing human genetics and anatomy, physiology and behavior, we might conclude that humans have an intelligent creator who wrote the language of DNA and engineered our biology. But the conclusion I heard in university is that we are the result of unguided evolution from scum. Now, we could debate this all day and even lay out some pretty intelligent arguments pointing to some kind of creator. But we wouldn't know for sure who that creator was or exactly what happened at the beginning of time because we were not there to see it. In this case, however, we have eyewitness testimony to make up for our gaps in the data. We have the Word of God, who's the only one who has always been there, who knows everything, who cannot lie, and who reveals the history of human origins in His Word. That's why we want to make God's Word, not fallible human reasoning, the foundation for our thinking in every area. In fact, we're only able to discover facts and reason logically about them in the first place because our minds resulted not from random chance, but from a logical God who created a logical universe. Ultimately, then, there are two kinds of science, and the foundation of God's Word lets us reason accurately about both. For more on how to think critically about any faith-challenging message, you can access my other CT scan videos packed with tactics, tips, and tools that helped me as a Christian student at secular university. Thank you for watching. Hey, it's Patricia. Just wanted to let you know that if you like these videos, a free, easy way to help Answers in Genesis Canada produce more content and equip more people to defend their faith is to hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, click the bell, and of course, share these resources. I know you might hear that kind of thing a lot, but the reason these actions are so important is they inform social media algorithms to help these videos reach more people who can benefit from them. And that's especially helpful because advertising is super expensive. But this way, even media platforms which are often unfriendly towards biblical content become tools to promote gospel outreach for free. And if you're on board to share this message of biblical authority and want to give, you can also make a one-time donation or become a monthly supporter by clicking the link below. Thank you so much.